the cross was offensive to many in the beginning. Much of what Jesus said, I mean, look at his battles with the scribes and the Pharisees throughout his 3 years of public ministry. Christ says he came to divide us in a, that sense, to divide us from anything that is false. And this bishop's words, would that they were words coming from a pope. Those are the kind of words we need. And this time, in the 21st century, we need that kind of clarity, that kind of zeroing in on exactly what people of faith are thinking and wondering. And it's like, how can this be? And as he said so appropriately, but very clearly, this couple, that all these things they're doing as a couple, it is just inauthentic, and it is it's ludicrous to pretend that this document says anything else, except it's like sleight of hand. That is not the church. It never has been. I really share his pain, but we have to be very clear that this is not the way of the church of Jesus Christ, the church that he established, that he bled for and rose. So the risen part, we always have to remember, because we get burdened with the crosses we bear in this time. But as you said, John Henry, this bishop out of Africa reminds us, yes, there's a cross, but the joy and the hope of resurrected life, of eternal life, that's what the point of it all is. And I picked that up in what the bishop says as well. Even as he's saddened, his sadness is that too many will remain in confusion and not see the light at the end of the path of the cross.
This is Archbishop Maurice Makumba, the Archbishop of Kisumu in Kenya. Just listen to this.
I'm not thinking of any possibility of any of you coming to me, asking me to bless you because you're homosexual. I don't expect. I know you can't come. I know you can't come. Not the Archdiocese of Kisumu. I'm saying this because the document that was issued by the Congregation of the Doctrine of Faith has caused a lot of misunderstanding. And many of you have come to ask me, many of you have come to ask our priests, which way the Catholic Church, and I say, the Catholic Church's teaching on holy matrimony has not changed. It is prohibited for any priest in the Archdiocese of Kisumu to attempt to bless a union, a homosexual union, whether it is in the church or outside the church. Do you understand me, please? Yes, it is prohibited for any priest or any deacon to attempt to bless a homosexual relationship. Because instead of bringing people closer to the church and to the faith, it is going to push people away from the faith and from the church. And this is not what we expect in the Archdiocese of Kisumu.
The church hasn't stayed strong. The church hasn't stayed true to herself. But thankfully, the heart is always there. The Immaculate Heart of Mary, the Sacred Heart of Christ, the Chaste Heart of St. Joseph, those three hearts that continue to beat a human heart in Christ, divine and human. But the heart is still there. But the human side of the church has been weak in our lifetime. And it's reaching a crescendo of that weakness in our lifetime. What occurs to me is, it's funny because I was Bishop of Tyler, probably one of the most rural parts of Texas, a beautiful part of Texas. But in growing up in this earth To me, that's what, you know, I have in common with these bishops of Africa. I mean, one of the bishops spoke about people walking 2 hours to get to Mass. I mean, here in Texas, I mean, if you're walking anywhere, people think you need a ride because, you know, we're in, even here now, we're in a culture where we're at least once removed from the earth, from just the basic truth. But I really feel like that's part of what has given me strength. And I think that's what I hear from these African bishops. You know, we speak of Africa too often as like a third world, but in many ways, spiritually, we're seeing it is a first world, and it's God's world.